An early morning trail ride again. It's been about 5 days, thanks to the holidays, since I've been out here. Plus, I've been riding e-bikes, but I'm out with the huge poison oak vines, and I'm really close to the street, right on the edge of the trail, so I may have to do extra cuts here just to filter out traffic. But I did want to do kind of an extra special video today because I'm getting close to 100,000 subscribers, so I thought I would break this out, Project Hydra. I did make one mistake though. I cleaned it up before I came out here. I wanted it to look all shiny and new, but now I'm kind of regretting doing that because it doesn't have that mountain bike look to it without the dirt. But here it is, and after all this time, it's still doing well though. Admittedly, I don't ride this all that much, but I have had a few different people ride it over the course of its existence and its final form here. And some of those, I've even wrapped the frame before I handed it to them, just to keep that beautiful blue intact. So the big question would be, how has it held up? Well, it's held up really well, although there are a few exceptions. This is not the original wheel set. I think this is about the third of the same type wheel set with these Continental Race Kings. These are what? STP, the WTB STP I-25s. You know, I used to buy those by the gross when they were available, but over time I would either swap to another bike or trade off or even sell off to people that needed a wheel set. Now I'm kind of wishing I hadn't done that because I could really use more of these. That said, for these trails, these tires work great and the wheel sets are lighter weight, and of course they help me transition away from free wheels and into cassettes. And this is one of my earliest uses, if not the earliest use, of an IXF crankset. Still working fine. And this, you know, I used to go with SRAM NX on everything because it was the cheapest best for quite a while and still pretty good. And no Fookers here. Legit race face Chesters. Still working great, although I think this is the third set that I've put on. I've taken them off over time. Again, for other bikes, but race face Chesters. What about those nylon pivot bushings? No problems. I don't think I've ever even really had to tighten these down after the first ride or two. All the pivots still working well. I don't expect any problems anytime. And again, I'm not doing jumps on these bikes, but still no problems with the nylon nor the DNM, what is this, the AOI 36 RC shock. People ask me what dimension shock I used on this. It's a 190mm DNM. Now some people use a 200, but that tilts things up just a bit in the back, so I use the 190. Still holds its air pretty well. Now over about 6 months I will have to put a little bit of air in it, but overall does a really good job, especially for the money. I think I paid $79 for this, $69, $79. The bars, these are Ace Kit Jessica's, or Jessica Ace Kit, not sure which way I should be saying that, but these particular bars are 780mm wide. You know, I've kind of reverted down to 720 as my preferred bar width for the local trails here, but on this bike though, I was expecting this morning. I haven't ridden this in, like I said, 6 months or so, maybe even more, and I would have expected that this would have been a nuisance feel for me, but no, actually quite comfortable. Some of that could be due to the upright geometry. Had to do an impromptu reposition because there were just too many cars going by, but these bars in conjunction with this head tube angle, you know, which is a little big box steep, but surprisingly not an issue. And this is all when I was still, you know, kind of in a guessing game with some of these components, but it has all come together pretty well here. And this is the bike that I think I discovered the Suntour Apixon air forks on. This one, I think this is 120mm. Has a remote lockout I never put the control on the bar for, but you know, an air fork, these are good forks. Really underrated and underappreciated, and I appreciate that because that means I can still get them even during the fork shortage. The price has went up, but these are still available for the most part. Good, good forks. My biggest surprise here with this bike is with this geometry and the water bars, it's still super comfortable to me. Even after riding Project Comp V2, my favorite Project bike, but I will say there is one thing about that. You know, Project Comp V2 is a hardtail, and I'm typically a hardtail kind of rider, but after, I think over the last 2.5 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, ever since I did that Salvo Pro video, whenever that was, where I had it out here on the trail, I rode that Salvo Pro for probably 2 weeks straight. out on the trail is my preferred bike. Not to say I didn't get anything else out here, just the one that I preferred. Then I rode that Cannondale Lefty, and now Project Hydro, all full suspension. And you know, there is, comfort-wise, a big difference between the plushness of a full suspension out on the trail, hitting, you can't really see them, but there is a million of these roots out here at Wildwood. I'm just about 20 feet away from where I was. It's nothing but big, thick roots every few feet. And going from a hardtail to a full suspension bike on roots like this, something that you quickly notice. At least I notice it. My bottom and my back and all the other parts notice the smoothness from the full suspension. So you may ask, well, why don't you ride full suspension bikes more often? Well, A, they're more expensive, more services involved, and B, a full suspension bike robs a little bit of power when going uphill an area that I already struggle on. I can tell you today, pedaling this, my Fitbit was going off. It buzzed so many times telling me I was at different cardio levels. Wasn't sure if I'd reached some new achievement or if it was just auto-dialing 911 for me, because I was huffing it. So if I had to do this over again, is there anything I would change about Project Hydro? Well, really not much of anything. Now, the Snafu saddle. In previous videos, I've went from over the past couple of years from really liking these Snafu saddles, not so much for their comfort. They're not comfortable, but they're not uncomfortable for the most part. And I did dig that Snafu name. I thought that was just kind of funny cool. But recently I rode a bike that had a Snafu, and I said that it's kind of less comfortable than I remembered. And then I figured out I didn't have my mountain bike shorts on, which have padding. I was just in sweatpants, so that's the reason. But these aren't that comfortable. They're not that uncomfortable. It's more just kind of a looks versus comfort preference, but I would probably switch this out for something different. I would change the SRAM NX. Nothing wrong with it. They work great, but I found that that Advent 10 is a little bit lighter, and they shift so well, and they're about $30, $35, $40 cheaper than this. So why not save a little bit of coin and go with that? But if this was all I had available, still fine. These are good drivetrains. They work well, doesn't beat the chainstay to death with chain slap, and really that's all you need in a mountain bike. There's not a lot of chain slap and something that reliably will shift even on rough terrain, and the NX gets the job done there. Could Hyper do anything to make this better in its base form? Well, absolutely. Number one, they could bring back the bike. Why? They canceled this and went with that Explorer full suspension that looks a lot like it, but has a smaller frame, which that's okay. But that rear triangle being still, I mean, why? Why did you mess this up? Such a good bike. But if you do bring it back, how about giving it a tapered head tube? Like Schwinn does with their bikes, that would make this amazing. Well, I'm gonna get back on the trail, start riding a little more before people start showing up. But there's kind of a quick update on Project Hydro, still holding together. Admittedly, not ridden as much as I should be riding it. Now, don't loan this out a lot just because I don't want that beautiful finish messed up, but Project Hydro still holding together, doing well. None of the concerns that any people weighed about this suspension or the linkage, I haven't had any problems. It's all worked out just fine. And you know that I like it enough that I wouldn't really change anything about it. Maybe go with the Advent in the rear here just to save some bucks if I was doing it all over again. But this is a bike that there is no doing over again just because it's gone away. Hyper, bring this back, please. We really need this bike back. Well, it hasn't completely gone away because there is one Hydroform still out there waiting for a new owner, and that's the one that I'm going to be giving away on January the 1st to one of my patrons, a random lucky patron. And this isn't a cue for you to go over if you're not already a patron on my Patreon to sign up, though I would appreciate that, but that's not a cue for that because of the way Patreon bills, you wouldn't get in time for that giveaway anyway. But it's still bone stock sans. I did put a 1x on it, though, used in that square taper 1x video that I made. January the 1st, someone getting a hyperhydro form of their very own to do whatever they want to do project wise with it. So one person gonna ring in 2021 in a very non-2020 way with their own new hyperhydro form. Now back to the trail, and thanks again for everyone that helped me get to 100,000 subscribers. I mean, probably just a day away if it doesn't even happen today. But for those of you that were in before 100K, I really appreciate it. Anybody that comes after that, I appreciate you as well. This channel is going to continue to grow, and lots of great things on the docket for 2021. And I make videos like this. They aren't very high volume videos view-wise for me. I just enjoy doing them, and it kind of helps those of us that have been with Kev Central for so long get together and have at least a one-way conversation and share a little bit of bike information that the core of us seem to enjoy. I'm going to edit this in because I thought this was pretty funny, but this is a section of the trail heading towards the end as I'm leaving, and there's some curves. It's mostly hard packed dirt. It's a little kind of almost tabletop thing here, and if you want to, you can go around it. And you come down, and this is funny, and this is how I know some people got them some new bikes. They're trying them out on the mountain bike trail for Christmas, because coming down to this, there is that. And look at this. I never see this. But I mean dugout ruts where people are trucking it down this, because it's just enough of a hill to get up some good speed and have some fun on some curves. And then if you don't know that this is here, there's a tree, and you can see that trail's a little obscured there to the left, but look where they have dug in here, hitting the brakes. I mean, even gotten a little sideways, and oh no, I'm about to go off of this, which on video, nothing looks like it actually is, but that's probably 4 feet and a nice gap there before the landing. So imagine if you hadn't ever ridden a mountain bike before and you're out on your new mountain bike, you're trucking it down this, and you get here and see that you are about to go off that. At least I found that funny, thought I would share it. And now back to wherever I was in the video. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Thanks for watching Kev Central, and don't forget the notification bell. Everyone have a great day.